G'day mate, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another FPL video. If you're new around here, please make sure you subscribe to the channel and yeah, drop this video a like if you do like it. In today's video, we're going to be looking at game week 23, all the questions from the community, so from Twitter, from YouTube, answering some big questions and looking forward to the recent announcement of the double/blank game week 25. And yeah, looking at some of the best players to buy from teams that will be doubling. So first up, we'll just look at the teams from game week 23 who will be doubling. Just a quick reminder. So Arsenal, they have Brentford at home, City at home, and Man City have Villa at home and Arsenal away. Not the best double game week for either side as they do face each other and they are the two best teams in the league based on current positions. But yeah, both have a really good home fixture to partner that too. Also, the recent announcement, so we've got confirmed blank game weeks for game week 25. So Man United will blank Newcastle, Brentford and Brighton. This is because Man United and Newcastle are in the League Cup final. So they will be missing their game against the other two teams in order to play that final. We also got a big announcement yesterday. So Arsenal, Everton, Liverpool and Wolves will be blank, will be doubling in blank game week 25. So it will be a double blank game week. Arsenal have a really, really good double. So Leicester away, who have been shipping a lot of goals recently, and Everton at home. Although Everton did beat them recently, you expect Arsenal to win that game comfortably, being the home side and being at the Emirates. Everton have Villa at home and Arsenal away. Again, it's only been one game since Sean Dyche came in, but Everton do look better already, so maybe one of them defensive options could be an asset and then a tough game against Arsenal. Liverpool, so I put them down as grey fixtures because how bad Liverpool are. I would say recently, but all season. So Palace away and Wolves at home. Wolves just beat them 3-0 at Molineux. So again, not the easiest fixture. And Palace away is always a tough one for Liverpool. And then Wolves have Fulham away and Liverpool away. Two tough games against a good team in Fulham, and who knows, Liverpool might turn up on a day and make it difficult for Wolves and wanting that revenge for that 3-0 3-0 loss this week. So for me, I'm looking at bringing in, well, you should already have three Arsenal, but if not, bringing in three Arsenal players and maybe Everton or Liverpool. For Wolves, I think two away games is tough. Wolves don't really score that many goals, so maybe a defender, but I'm sure we'll talk about that more later on and closer to the double game week. So we'll move on to the community questions. First question is from Twitter, so from Tams. So top three differential picks for those wanting to play a bit more aggressively. Brilliant question. I know a lot of people have been looking to trying to make that move as a lot of teams now are looking very similar, kind of Haaland and Trippier, Arsenal players, and there's kind of lacking that almost next differential. Obviously, if a differential is obvious, then it's probably not a differential anymore. But here are some of the best options, I think, are differentials for the coming weeks. I've actually based this on the next 6 weeks, so up until game week 28. So I've just gone for a defensive midfielder and then a forward option. So for a defensive option, Reece James coming in at 5.7 million. He's just over the differential class of 10%, 11.9%. But I'm sure that is a lot of dead teams, the people that don't play anymore. He is expected 18.8 points over the next 6 game weeks. And Chelsea actually play in game week 25 and game week 28. Reece James hasn't really played that much all season. He is coming back from injury. He's only got a goal and assist as well, but came back against Fulham, played 59 minutes for those that are still got him, which is unlucky as I did keep a clean sheet. But a real punt, someone that we know that can return. He hasn't showed it this season, obviously through the injuries, but we know he can return. And we know he's got goals and assists in him. His fixtures are looking really, really good too. So West Ham away, Southampton home is a good fixture. Tottenham away, which Chelsea always do well against. Leeds at home, Leicester away, and then Everton at home in blank game week 28. So yeah, really good player to kind of hold throughout the blanks, have and start and hopefully get a few points. And Chelsea have been doing really, really well recently in terms of defences. So They've kept three clean sheets in a row, and they're kind of looking pretty solid defensively. Next up in the midfield, so this is a proper punt. So McNeil, Dwight McNeil for Everton. So he did get an assist against Arsenal, that goal from a corner. And although he hasn't really done much all season, two goals, two assists, he is a ex-Burnley player. So Sean Dyche probably likes him. And if he's on set pieces, we can expect a Sean Dyche team to get a lot of goals, a lot of headers from set pieces, and kind of maybe relying on that for their goals. So he does come in at 5.1 million, so perfect for your bench. Maybe another option instead of Matoma for that same price point. Obviously, Matoma is the better player, but he does blank in 25 and potentially could blank in 28. So he is 0.1% owned, so a massive differential, over 16 points over the next six. And yeah, just probably that fifth midfielder, someone to have on the bench, maybe to play in the doubles, as we've just seen Everton do double in game week 25 too. So their fixtures are as follows: Liverpool away, which probably is not as tough as you thought. Leeds at home, Everton at home, Arsenal away in a double game at 25. So Villa at home, Arsenal away, Forest away, Brentford at home, and then Chelsea away in the blank game week. Then they do have Spurs and Man United after that. So it might be time to sell after that blank game week. But yeah, set pieces. If kind of Everton are going to score goals, then it'll probably be involving McNeil. Next up for the forward lines, I've gone with João Félix. Not the best debut and start to his Premier League career with a sending off. So he comes in at 7.5 million. His ban is done now, so he will be back for Chelsea's next Premier League game. 0.4% owned and is expected nearly 14 points over the next six. So I've already gone through the Chelsea fixtures, so I won't go through again. But Chelsea, like I said, do play in the blank game weeks, both game week 25 and game week 28. And they do have some really nice fixtures around that. For me, I just feel like players like Modric or some of the other players, maybe not Enzo, but some of the other players that Chelsea have brought in, I feel like that's for the future, but João Félix is for now. He is on loan, so there's no point bringing a player in on loan if you're not going to play him. And although he can play at front, I'll probably see him more in that number 10 position, maybe playing off Havertz or even playing instead of Havertz as kind of a false nine. And we know his quality. We've seen it in the Champions League, and we've seen it for Real Madrid over the years, Atletico Madrid over the years. And a real, real fun punt. And if Chelsea do get their scoring boots on, then he could be a great option. Although they haven't scored one goal in the last three games, and the defence has kind of been that main area to kind of target if you are bringing in Chelsea. Surely they have to start scoring soon with some of the players, some of the injuries being back. Enzo, Modric, Reece James and Chilwell now back as well. Some more creativity from the width. And yeah, fancy Felix to get a few goals. So thanks to Chatstop Football for this next question. So barring Trippier and Haaland, who are the most essential players? So for me, as we've just seen, Arsenal will double twice in the space of three game weeks. So for me, the most essential players are three Arsenal players. So the triple up, if you don't have the triple up, then please get it done, because you're kind of missing out there. They will play in game week 25 and double, and they will be playing in game week 28 too. So they basically cover all bases. You get a couple doubles. You get the players to play in the blanks. And for me, you need to be tripled up on Arsenal. Let's quickly run through their fixtures once again, going up until game week 28. So Brentford at home, City at home in a double, Villa away, and then Leicester away, Everton at home in a double, Bournemouth at home, Fulham away in game week 27, and then Palace at home in game week 28 in the blank. They also got Leeds after that at home. So really, really good fixtures. A couple doubles in there, and they are essential. You need the triple up. For me, these are the best three players if I could choose. I can't actually get to these with the way my team's structured, but if you had to choose and you've got the opportunity to get these players, then go for it. I'd go for Gabriel, a nice solid defensive option. I can see a few clean sheets in there. Arsenal haven't been, let's say, amazing defensively, but they have looked solid. And at 5.2 million, Gabriel is a really good option and a goal threat too. So he's only 13.6% owned, but he's expected 30 points over the next six game weeks. And he's only got two goals this season, but with these doubles, I fancy him to get a goal and a few clean sheets. So Gabriel, if you do want to go for that defensive option. And I think the best way of playing this is going for two midfielders. I could go Nketiah, which is great, great value, but Jesus could be back soon and it could ruin all your plans. You want these teams, because they've got doubles, you don't want them to end up playing one game. It's just horrible kind of thing. So Odegaard, 7 million, 35.1% owned, so really highly owned. Over 32 points he is projected. So he's really, really surprised me this season. He is the highest scoring Arsenal player. So like, he's at top of the league, so fantastic. He has got 8 goals, 6 assists, and he's been kind of ticking along and coming with them double-digit hauls, 3 double-digit hauls from 16 to 18 game week, that is. And I fancy him to come and tick along, assist, goals, and be that kind of creative spark. Also, I've gone for Saka, who will be on penalties, 8.3 million. He is the most expensive out of these three. 26.6% owned, so lower owned than Odegaard, which actually really surprised me, and projected over 33 points over these next six game weeks. So, like I said, Saka is on pens. 7 goals, 8 assists, which is fantastic, but I just feel like he can get more, to be honest. He's kind of doesn't have that rivalry or that worry for his place, like, say, Martinelli, or even even Odegaard has Fabio Vieira there. But Saka, I don't feel like there's anyone on that right-hand side that can take his place. And I just fancy him, although he's not done as well as Odegaard, I fancy him to bang so many goals over the next six game weeks, and Arsenal to get a few penalties too. So for me, most essential players are 3 Arsenal players, and it's these 3. Let me know below who you think the most essential players are. So another great question by Tams on Twitter. So should I use my triple captain on Haaland? So I'm actually thinking of the same question. I'm not too sure what I'm going to do. So I still have my triple captain to play. And for me, these are the options if you wanted to use your triple captain this week. So in the long of the short of it is, I'm probably going to wait and use my triple captain on Haaland. Whether it's this week or not, I'm not 100% sure. But these are the options if you do want to play it this week. So Saka, pretty good fixture. Brentford at home, 2 home games against City at home. City haven't looked that good recently. Spurs beat them the other day. Defensively, I don't think they know what they're doing. So Diaz and Laporte was benched. Kyle Walker hasn't really played much. They've let Cancelo go out on loan. So I fancy Arsenal to score in that game, and they do have that other home game against Brentford. So Saka is expected 8.2 points in this game week. So not the best, but not the worst. I think you can do better though. Another option is Nketiah. He's done really, really well recently. 2 goals against Man United, really low owned. So kind of almost a differential, especially if you go for him for captain or triple captain, just under 8. Points projected this game week. So again, not the greatest, but has that good fixture and 2 home games. De Bruyne is another player people are looking at. So a lot of money, so you might have to bring him in for, say, Bruno Fernandes, but we'll cover that later on in the video. Expected 9 points. Again, tough fixture against Arsenal away, but it does have a home game, and City do look pretty good at home when they have played at home this season, although their away form hasn't been great. And then now on to Haaland. So obviously massively owned, will probably be triple captain by a few people. I'd expect his effective ownership to be probably 220, 230, so around 20% of people playing the triple captain on Haaland. So he is expected a massive 11.2 points. So way more than anyone else. He does have that home fixture, and he loves playing at home. The only thing that's putting me off is his record against the big 6 side. So he's only scored 1 goal, which was against Spurs, and then he scored obviously a hat-trick and 2 assists against Man United. But he's blanked against Spurs away, blanked against Liverpool, blanked against think it was Chelsea. Yeah, basically blanked against Newcastle too. So his record hasn't been great, but he does have that Villa at home game, and then you're kind of having the Arsenal game as an away from home as a bonus. For me, I'd probably wait. I think I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait for a better double game week for City. I'm pretty sure I want to play it on Haaland, although I'm trying not to be swayed by the recent City performance against Spurs. The fact that Haaland rarely had any touches. I'm just trying to look at the facts, and the facts is he scores goals for Fran. He scored 25 goals this season already, and I'd probably kick myself if I didn't play on Haaland. And yeah, he went crazy and scored two hat tricks in a double game week. So for me, I'd wait. I feel like I've been saying this a lot of the time, but I'd wait for a better double game week for Erling Haaland. So the next question is for my good friend FPL Matt Day. If you've not subscribed already, go check out his channel. So it comes on about Spurs assets. So thoughts on Spurs assets other than the King Harry Kane. So Harry Kane recently was crowned Tottenham's greatest ever goal scorer. So most goals for any player that has played for Spurs and has scored for Spurs. So I'm sure, like FPL Matt Day, he's a Spurs fan like I am. He's probably looking at ways to get more Spurs players into his team. And I'm exactly the same. I'm sure if you support a team, you always want to kind of get players in from the team you support, if possible. And Kane is kind of an easy one, but who else can we basically get in from Spurs, and who else is a good option? So Spurs have some really, really good fixtures coming up. So Leicester away, West Ham at home, Chelsea at home in a blank game week. Wolves away, Forest at home, and Southampton away in the blank game week. So that is likely to be a blank if Spurs do get through to the next round. They do play Sheffield United away, which can be tough, but they're in the Championship, so you'd expect Spurs to win that game. So some really, really good fixtures though. But for me, there's probably only two options I'd consider bringing into my team for Spurs, and that is the new signing Pedro Porro. Although he hasn't played yet, so the first game was against Man City, and Conte, or the assistant, as Conte was ill in hospital, decided to keep Emerson Royal. Emerson Royal had a great, great performance. But I do feel like eventually Porro will be our first choice right wing back. So coming in at 5 million, again, still very low owned, 0.2 owned, and he's expected just under 19 points over the next six game weeks. He is a very, very attacking right wing back. He was great for Sporting Lisbon, and when we played him in the Champions League, he basically tore us apart, to be honest. And we all know how fantastic, how kind of goal scoring and assisting Conte's wing backs can be, although we haven't really seen that a lot. Perisic is probably a best example. He's got 5 assists, no goals, but he should have had more goals, definitely. Royal, 1 goal, 2 assists, and Sessegnon has 2 goals, 1 assist. Doherty did well last season as well, and I fancy Pedro Porro to kind of be that right wing back that we always thought Conte's teams will have. And at 5 million, and how defensively solid Spurs have been the last 2 to 3 games. So they have kept clean sheet against Man City, kept one against Fulham as well, so, and one in the cup. So been doing really, really well. Another player is Kulusevski, 7.9 million, 4.1% owned, and is expected just over 16 points over the next six. So another asset that could be good to double up on that Spurs attack. I wouldn't be using him to cover Kane's points. Although Kulusevski can score and can assist, he has been injured a lot of the season. So he doesn't show that in his kind of total points tally. Spurs are a lot more creative with Kulusevski, but that doesn't mean I'd bring him in. For me, Kane is the only option right now. But definitely, definitely keep an eye on Pedro Porro. And as Spurs kind of need their wing-backs to start pulling their weight, and we all know in the Conte system, wing-backs are crucial to the way he plays. So now we have a question that I'm sure a lot of people have been wondering from Tams from Twitter. So is Bruno to KDB slash Mahrez essential? So a lot of people did bring in Bruno for a double for Man United's game week 22 double. They kind of did that mostly through taking out KDB, and then we're looking to bring KDB back in. So I did say this last week, just slightly, not as obvious, but I did say I don't think it's worth doing KDB to Bruno to back to KDB. For me, I think Mahrez is the better option, although his predicted points over the next six are not as good as Bruno or KDB. I feel like he's a bigger goal threat, as shown in kind of the stats for this season. KDB, let's be honest, I know I don't want to say this because he is a great player, but KDB hasn't been as good as we know he can be, really. He's only scored 3 goals this season. Having said that, 12 assists is massive, is really, really massive. But you want for that price, 12.4 million, you want goals. Like, there's no simpler way to pull it. You get points by scoring goals, getting bonus. Although assists is great, for me, I'd rather the goal threat. Mahrez only has one more goal in him, but he has played significantly less minutes than KDB. And he also has 5 assists. And he's way, way cheaper. He's almost 5 million cheaper. So for me, I'd go, if you did want that Man City third options, because I'm sure a lot of you have, say, Edison or a defender, Ake Akanji, and obviously Haaland. So if you did want that third Man City option, I'd go for Mahrez just for the price. You're not really stressing if he doesn't perform. With KDB, 12.4 million, you need him to perform. You need him to be getting a return every week at least. So for me, I actually don't think that is essential. I don't think the third Man City player is essential. Bruno has some really good fixtures coming up too, although it's not a double. That doesn't mean anything if Mahrez or KDB get benched. It's still one game and 30 minutes, so they'll come on. For me, Bruno is not that much of a bad option. So Leeds at home, obviously they have this week, so that won't count. Leeds away, so you've got Leeds away, Leicester at home. Whereas City, they have the double game week. They have Villa at home, Arsenal away, and then Forest away. Forest have been doing really, really good defensively and really good at home. So it's not as easy as you think. For me, I don't think it's essential. I think if you want to get that third City, then fair enough. If you don't have a third Arsenal, go to an Arsenal player. Go to Saka, go to Odegaard from Bruno. But if not, then I'd stick with Bruno. I wouldn't go for that third City. Well, it wouldn't be essential. Let me know below what you think. Thank you all for watching. Leave me a comment below answering all the questions. Let me know your thoughts. Please like this video too, as it really, really helps out the channel. If you are new around here, make sure you subscribe to the channel. I know a lot of you watch and don't subscribe, and it will really, really help me out. I do put out 2 to 3 FPL videos every single week, so for great content to help you with your mini leagues, help you gain momentum and rise up the ranks. But yeah, I'll catch you in the next one.